Hello, welcome to my Red Dead Redemption blind playthrough, episode 37. My name is Spriggett, and we're going to jump right in. Let me get my face off the screen, because if you watched episode 36, you know that it took me a couple tries because I forgot to do that. So, I need to figure out what I'm doing. I just recorded 36 the day before this one. So, but I still don't remember what I was doing.
Oh, yes! I know about you. I do.
Hello there. Today I have the ceiling fan on, so you might hear that. I think my mic picks up the ceiling fan. It's got kind of a steady humming kind of a sound. And there is a chance that you will hear a mockingbird outside the window. We've had some move into the neighborhood last year. I don't know where they came from or why they chose us, but they are very, very annoying. And they have this sound that they make, and I think it's like when they're in distress they make this sound, and it's just obnoxious. You're the guy that kills me. Okay. Anyway, so I tried to wait until the mockingbirds were done with their noisiness this morning, but they're birds, and they're wild, so who knows, you might hear it again. I can't tell through the headphones, so it might pop up and I have no idea. Alright, let's figure out, actually I should probably visit the doctor and see if I can get supplies. Let's do that.
Medicine in Blackwater all my life. I'm gonna place officers in every corner on Saturday. Excellent choice.
So glad I have medicine again.
I just might find something to my liking.
I'm sure you will. Big horns.
Why, hello, Mr. Austin?
That won't cure typhoid if you have it.
Well, I hope I don't have typhoid. Can you imagine?
If any of my cures don't work, you come back and see me.
I don't think we realize how lucky we are to live in the day and age we do. Well, I'm sure some of us realize it, but right. I mean, so many things that are treatable now that weren't then. I mean, more treatable. To where there's a less likely chance you'll die from things. Alright.
That's what I've got for sale.
If you have any more symptoms, you take a double dose.
Double dose, huh?
Remember me? I'm God.
Okay, I'm seeing initials or letters. Okay, it is. I was making sure it was actually in the town and I wasn't just going this way for nothing. Could probably go faster than that, huh? Not really. Alright. This guy again. 6 p.m. Really? Well, you know what? I'm just gonna go ahead and sleep. That's quite a bit of time to have to wait, so.
These cards are ready for your hand. Yes.
That's okay. All right. Can I go there now? What time is it? It's 4:15.
The carriages just ran over a Chinaman. I saw it.
Oh.
So I've heard.
Well, that's too bad, I guess. Okay.
Forgive me, sir.
For what? We weren't even close together.
Hello. I hope I find him bad.
Where does my horse go? And why aren't there hitching posts here? You know? With as many people that still use horses. You know, I think there are some states that still have laws on the books that businesses have to have a hitching post outside of their business. If you're feeling... Whoa. What's the word I'm looking for? I am so sorry. Also have allergies acting up. Whoa! Didn't mean to do that. Hello. Anyway, one of these times, you know, get your horse, ride into town, and demand that the business put a hitching post outside. Make sure your state has that law, though, if you're in the U.S. I'm just kind of walking up and down the road to waste time at this point. Look at the... Let me put my phone on data, because I didn't do that, but I have the data myself today, because my work has a holiday. Hubs has to work. And I thought this will be the perfect day to record some videos, because I'm by myself, I'm the only one using the internet, but no, I'm still getting... you know. I like this trotting. I don't know why. I'm sure it would jostle your bones a little bit in real life, but it's kind of cool to be in the game. Whoop! No, 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 no. I can't get it to do it now. Come on. Come on. There we go. I'm just killing time. Can I run over the officers? They still got some road cobbling to do. Come on now. Four minutes. Why does everybody know me here? That's what I want to know. Okay, is it time now? Yes, it is. The prodigal son returns to Yale.
Professor!
Shut the door.
What's going on? You leaving?
Yes, sir. Yes, I am, sir. You know the thing that is vital, without which scholarship cannot proceed, sir?
No, I don't.
Not having a bullet in your flipping neck, sir. I'm not cut out for this. No, not cut out for this at all.
Nope.
They're fucking savages! Savages!
I think we all are.
Me, sir. I'm from Connecticut. I'm a professor at Yale. I write books. I do not deserve to die out here. Where's my tincture? Oh, yes.
I don't like watching needles go into things.
Dandy, sir. Just dandy.
I keep looking. Did they put something in it?
I think that's what they call two for the price of one out here in this wonderful place.
Maybe so, Dutch.
You and your friend there, the professor, we're gonna kill the both of you.
Why you wanna do a thing like that?
I don't know. Sport, I guess.
Fair enough. Why don't I come out there? We fight. Let the professor go and Send your boys back to their families.
Well, that sounds like a beautiful plan, John.
But?
Only problem is, my boys here, they already lost their families a long time ago. We aren't thieves, John. We're fighting for something a bit like you. Only we're fighting for an idea, not just for ourselves.
That's beautiful, Dutch. You always were a fine speaker.
I was. Now, would you kindly send that academic out here so we can show him what we really think about the art of anthropology?
So what are we going to do?
I'm gonna hand you over to him and watch him tear you limb from limb.
What?
I'm just kidding. We're gonna run across the rooftops. Get you back to your ivory tower.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. We're still here. Come on.
Yes. Oh, come here.
Good day, sir. Madam.
Look here, sir. What is the meaning of this outrage?
You two stay down and shut up.
This way.
Oh, yay, my favorite. Come on.
Do something! He's going to kill me!
I will feast on your blood. You're the next survivor.
My God, you took your sweet time! What do we do now? They've got us pinned down on both sides.
All right, where are they? Oh, I see all the little red dots. Okay. Ah, no, I don't want this. Stop changing my weapon. See, at least with this one, it auto-aims for me, and I can get him just fine. Okay, that's that side. Where are they? Oh, I see. Oh. Okay. Come on. They peek and hide, and it's really annoying. Yeah, I don't like the sniper in this game. Too many people that can just get you from the side. Come on, peek again. Alright.
I think that's most of them. The coast looks clear.
Come on then! Let's make a break for it!
Alright, do let's. Oh, great.
The horses should be in an alleyway down here!
I have to shoot people while I'm riding again.
Right to the station. I'm not staying in this place a minute longer.
Y'all need to get out the way. Yeah, because we're going to shoot people here in a minute. You know it. Yep.
Come on! I can't believe this! This is not safe enough!
Oh, believe it, honey. It's happening. Ah! I'm gonna die, too. Look at all of them! Okay, I do have medicine, so let's take it. I did not abandon him! Okay. I don't like how these quests are going with the way that they let the person just go on ahead.
Get the hell out of Blackwater!
Like, you have to kill people, but your horse doesn't just go where you need it to go, and they let the NPC just ride way ahead of you.
But it turns out it's just people killing each other.
It always was, Professor. And the Old West ain't quite dead yet.
Oh, I know, Mr. Marston. Believe me, I know. Oh, my God! There's more of them!
Come on. See, I can't. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Gonna die. How am I gonna do this? How? I don't know how I'm gonna do this. There's too many. Does he have a different horse every time?
Right, to the station! I'm not staying in this place a minute longer! This really couldn't have gone more horribly wrong!
At least you got some good material for your next book!
You know, I dreamt of documenting the last days of the Old West. The romance, the honor, the nobility. But it turns out...
How many times I gotta hear this?
Each other.
It always was, Professor. And the Old West ain't quite dead yet.
Oh, I know, Mr. Marston. Believe me, I know.
Get out of the way.
Come on.
I'm gonna have to do the thing where I'm not talking again. Come on. Do I have a different gun? Why do I have a different gun? Why does it do that? This one, please. Of course there's more. Why wouldn't there be more? It's getting really annoying. They're too close together. What the? I did not abandon him! If he'd stop going ahead of me...
Come on! Let's get the hell out of Blackwater! Come on! Come on!
Whoa there!
Head for Manzanita Post! I'm taking the first train out of here! This really couldn't have gone more horribly wrong!
At least you got some good material for your next book!
You know, I dreamt of documenting the last days of the Old West! The romance, the honor, the nobility! But it turns out it's just people killing each other!
It always was, Professor! And the Old West ain't quite dead yet!
Trying to get ahead of him so I can get the jump on these guys. But I'm trying not to get too far ahead because I don't need that whole, you abandoned McDougal!
You're
Okay, 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 okay. It did my gun again!
Let's go!
Come on, pull out your gun. Please? There we go. I thought I had to reload. Can't keep up!
Come on! Come on!
Is that a pig? Oh my gosh. My poor hand did not like that.
Research is complete! Much as I thought. There's no civilizing this savage land.
Could have told you that for nothing.
Ah, but they'll give me a prize in New Haven for this. Well, they bloody better. Well, goodbye, Mr. Marston.
He forgot his stuff.
Best of luck, dear friend. So long, Professor.
So long, sir.
Yes, go home. Well, that was interesting, and it took me way too long to finish that. I wonder if the first couple times, if I had just kept going, if it would have completed. I don't know.
Come on.
I try to reflect on what I should have done differently, but I just don't know anymore. Okay, what do we have? The G's all the way over there. Let's do that. Oh, and let's mark it first. We have market. There we go. Mm-hmm. That's interesting. There it is.
If it isn't my old friend.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't this a beautiful spot?
Sure. What are you doing here?
My accounts. I'm an accountant.
Is that so?
In a way.
What's your name?
You know, it's the darndest thing. I can't remember.
Tell me your damn name and where you know me from.
Well, I know you're from Mexico. I know you're from back out west. Well, I know you from all over.
Tell me your name or I won't be responsible for my actions.
Oh, but you will. You will be responsible. This is a fine spot. See you around, cowboy.
Damn you!
Yes, many have.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, let's see. Interesting. Are we putting some supernatural things into this game now? Back to Blackwater. I'm gonna see if I can set up a camp. I hope so. Good. Travel. Play. Blackwater is not showing up. There it is. Like, come on. I need wireless headphones. I surely do.
Greetings, Mr. Marston.
I'm wondering if that X is going to tell me to come back at 7 a.m. Nope, that's Night Watch. Nope. No. Don't want to do that. Nothing wrong with the Night Watch. I just don't want to do it right now. I really should call my horse, right? Can I not run through here? There we go. Oh. Taking the long way around. Do some parkour. Yeah, 7 a.m. I can't imagine. Whatever. Yeah, I can sleep. I'm gonna get to my house before my horse gets here. Come on now. Try not to run over the dog. Oh, they're talking about bears killing people. My stomach is starting to growl. I'm not sure why. These cards are ready for your hand. Yes. That bearing's in Apollo Range. I've had plenty to eat. Okay. Here we are. Whoop. Slow down now. Get some ammo and sleep. Stretching my hands. Save it. Yes. Yes. And what time is it? 20 minutes to 7. 20 game minutes, not 20 real minutes. Yeah, I don't gamble because I don't want to, and I just have really, really bad luck, so... Nah. Let me guess, it's just this building up here, isn't it? No? No. It's further up. There's my horsey! 10 minutes. Yay for killing time! I know I didn't tell the horse. I still like this view. If my graphics were a little bit better, but I like the water and the sun on it. I think it looks cool. It's after 7. Let's do it.
Opportunity, and I gave you the opportunity to save your family, and you failed. How could I possibly reward you?
Marston, you're a public menace. We should have had you killed.
I wish you had. But since you didn't, where's my family?
Oh, spare me the noble savage fallen sword tribe. Will you, oh boy, it's nauseating. You don't wish to be dead. You're an insignificant creature desperately clinging on to life like the rest of the scum in this town. You like Dutch. He's a charming fellow. He makes sense. He's like one of those nature writers from back east. Only he takes things a tiny little step too far. rather than just loving the flowers and the animals and the harmony between man and beast. He shoots people in the head for money and disagreeing with them.
He's a goddamn killer.
Now, I'm not a great intellect, but the metaphysical leap from admiring the flower to shooting a man in the head because he doesn't like the flower is a leap too far. So, I know it's easy. You see, me and Archer, we're the bad guys. We enforce the rules. Now, while the rules may not be perfect, they're really not so bad.
Exactly. What's the alternative?
Yeah. See, I'll tell you what the alternative is. It's not complicated. It's about one man and his gun versus another man. Sure. Civilization may be dull, but the alternative, Mr. Marston, is hell.
And the way you enforce this civilization, this freedom for men to like or not like flowers, or whatever in God's name you were just talking about, is to kidnap a man's wife and son?
Well, I know there's contradictions. I'm not going to lie to you. As I said, I'm not a great intellect. Now, after the debacle with the army and the bank, we have to put Mr. Vanderlyn to rest ourselves. Will you help us?
Do I have any choice?
Now that you mention it, no.
Then what was that pretty speech in aid of?
I don't rightly know, but it sure felt good saying it.
Shall we, Mr. Marston?
Let's go.
These two, I can't. There'd be a bullet in one head and my gun to the other one, demanding my family. The end. Not this again. Yay! Okay. Who do I shoot? These?
Now keep your finger off that trigger until we get out of Blackwater.
Come quick! Take a look at this thing! Have you seen this? It's got a gun on the back!
In all my born day, I've never seen such a contraption.
I've never seen such a contraption.
They told me about these. The army's been building them in secret.
Oh my God. What kind of army?
And suddenly the conspiracy is not a conspiracy.
Be turning a few heads.
Our armed forces have no equal. We have made incredible progress the past few years.
Is that what you call it?
This isn't much more than a simple prototype. You should see what they're working on in Virginia. Soon there will be no war we can't win.
Until everybody gets them.
The army has made camp a little way outside town. They took word out a large cache of ammunition and food is stored there.
Vanderlyn's gang needs constant supplies, so that should be enough to draw them in.
No mistakes this time. You hear me, Marston?
I thought you were talking to Fordham.
So if I fail, I can skip this trip here next time. I'm sorry. I don't know. Okay, so what was the point of me standing on this gun?
Look, they brought the machine gun.
What's the word, Captain?
We spotted one of Dutch's men about an hour ago. I think he took the bait.
Let's get in position then. Have your men ready to run them down if you have to.
Alright, I guess we're not stopping there. I thought we were just gonna stop there for something, and that's why I'm like,
I guess so.
Why am I on the gun? Yeah, can we please just finish it? Because I am done with it. Give me my family!
Keep your eyes peeled.
Well, they're not potatoes. Well, really bad joke. Okay. We all know I'm so good with this gun, don't we? Ah! Yeah, the slightest turn and it's just all over the place. We all knew it was going to happen, didn't we? Didn't we? Yes, we sure did. All right, can we? Well, at least I get to start right here.
Fingers on the triggers, boys.
I am not good with this gun. Come on.
Targets on the horizon. Fire at will.
Whose will? Ah! Come on. I hate this gun. I hate it. Have I mentioned that I hate this gun? Ah! Well, they want to kill us. Okay, move! I'm trying to move it slow, but then it doesn't move at all. There's a lot. There's always a lot. Well, I'll try, but you've seen me with this gun. I mean, at least I don't have to reload, right?
We'll kill every last one of
you. Well, we'll try to kill every last one of you.
Look, they're running. Move out. Don't let them get away.
I'm just gonna keep shooting, because why not? Why won't that one die?
Right. This thing's a lot bumpier off the road. It's gonna be a mess if we have to follow them into the woods.
Which we probably will.
Insanity. I can hardly hold on.
Just shut up and drive, Fordham.
Get those men behind the arcs. Keep going.
What the hell you wanted to kill me?
Jeez, I'm gonna die again. Oh, I can't. I just can't with this gun. And I'm almost out of medicine. No! My last one. Takes me forever. See? Takes me forever to kill one guy. I gotta do all that again. So, like, when I move my stick, the gun just whoosh, all over the screen. Well, at least we're moving. And then if I try to go slow, it barely moves at all. See, I can't just get the dot on them.
Can't you hold this thing steady, Fordham? I'm trying my best, sir. Look out behind those rocks!
The Wilhelm scream all over the place in this game. Come on. See, I can't, and, takes me forever to kill one guy.
What is it with these people?
Well, they want us dead. Don't blame them, honestly. Die! Ugh! I'm dying again. I could see it already. Come on! I'm so dead. Sorry, guys. This whole video has been me trying and failing, and it's ridiculous. It'd be great if my cavalry could kill more people. I'm trying. They're just... Look, if I don't... I don't know. I almost want to skip over all my tries, but... I'm gonna die. We're going too fast and there's too many. Yep, I'm dead. I'm so freaking dead. I'm dead! How am I gonna do this? I don't know what else to do. I can't aim this thing. You see me aiming. I cannot aim. Oh my goodness. Alright, well...
Right! Things are a lot bumpier off the road. It's gonna be a mess if we have to follow them into the woods.
Shut up and try, Fordham! Look out behind those rocks!
They're making a big mistake!
Keep
going! Y'all. I was totally hyped to play this game today, and now I'm just ready to... I am not a rage quitter, but I'm thinking about converting. Yes, please keep going while I cannot kill everybody.
Take
I'm trying to focus and not talk this time.
That wagon's out of control! It's coming straight out of our cavalry!
Well, Mr. Marston, it seems like your mentor, Dutch, no longer looks quite so kindly to his student.
That man is insane.
So it seems.
I think we need to get him before sundown.
As you say, Captain. Otherwise, he'll be gone again.
And what if I say no?
Now, before I shoot you myself, let me just point out the obvious. The one person we have left that can appeal to Mr. Vanderlyn is the last person we know who knows him. Your wife.
That won't be necessary. Mr. Ross, Captain, let's go.
Mount up, man. Let's move out.
I'm glad I got through that. I'm sorry for how many tries it took. Oh my goodness. Okay, this is not gonna keep me up with them, I guess. So I'm gonna have to manually direct my horse.
So you're the one who's gonna kill him?
Dutch? Yep, that's what they keep telling
me. There we
me.
Go.
But if you feel like doing it, please be my guest.
This is suicide, if you ask me. My scouts have seen that fort of his. I wanted to wait for more men, but them city boys back there weren't having none of it.
And you answer to them?
Unfortunately, it seems that now we do.
Oh, okay.
You said you was in a gang with this Dutch Vanderlyn.
I was once. A long time ago.
Don't seem like the kind of fella you want to run with. Unless I completely misjudge your character, of course.
When he turned crazy, I left. At least I tried to leave. Till those suits back there came and knocking, threatened to kill my wife and son if I didn't go after them.
Strange times we live in, partner. Strange times.
Mm-hmm.
It's a funny business. Army, government men, criminals, with all due respect.
You're telling me.
Too many hands on the tiller, if you ask me. This is how mistakes happen. My boys don't know who's giving the orders no more.
Take it from me, mister. If we get up there, it ain't gonna matter. It'll be every man for himself.
Didn't I ride up here earlier? The last episode? I could be wrong. I'm just seeing all the snow and the little cabin thing over there, and I'm not sure. Not that it matters. Are we there yet?
Look at this. Snow.
Yeah, I was up here. Now. I had to cut out a large portion of that journey. It took a long time. those are the gates I tried to open earlier.
Go! Get down!
Forward!
Make sure I got my correct gun because I know how it likes to change guns on me.
That's it.
Where did all these fools come from?
Well, at least I don't have a machine gun this time, so that's nice. I am doing most of the work. Well, not really. is this ammo I can have? Yay.
Don't stop now, Marston.
Nah, shut up.
No prisoners.
All right, who's shooting me? They're dead. Okay, good.
I know he's covering me! Four of them! Are you gonna let us do all the work?
Come on. Yeah, I am. As much as you can do. I'm tired. Come on. Alright, well, I can't have that. Where are they?
I thought you were a killer. Hold them off.
I'm a looter.
Let's go, man. Move into the village. For the love of God.
Didn't I just trip a guy? I don't wanna! If I don't have to use that gun, I'd rather not. The rock. I could not get around the rock.
Push into the village. Come on, let's finish this.
Do let's. Dishonor on you. Dishonor on your cow. Peek again, come on. Can I please move? What gun do I have? Whoops. I seem to be reloading a lot. I'll probably reload more with that one, but that's okay. See the red dots.
I guess you boys lost this one.
Are we done? I didn't even have to use the Gatling gun. Thank goodness.
What have we got here?
Come on. What if there's anything in that tent? Doesn't look like it. Yeah, I'm just kind of looting now, because why not? They'll probably be like, you didn't catch up to your team. Okay. Here we are.
Right, Marston. We'll take two men with us. The rest will stay here and take care of the wounded. They'll plant charges at the gate. You and I will provide the cover fire. All right, man. Blow that gate open. Get ready to hold off their fire, Marston. Up top! Cover them! Lord and boss! What are you doing? Shoot them!
I am. What are you doing? Oh, I thought there was another one.
Oh,
there you are.
You idiot!
Ah!
Tend to your wounded. I gotta face Dutch alone. Looks like it's me and you, John. You should have stayed at home.
I suggest you follow me.
United States Army.
Quiet.
Working for the government, John.
Oh, it aimed for me. That's good. Come on.
Son of a bitch! God damn it! You'll never take me alive, John!
Famous last chase him, huh? I don't wanna. Am I gonna catch on fire? I am sorry that I found that so funny. I don't know where to go. I don't know where to go. Where do I go? That way? I went the wrong way, didn't I? Oh my goodness me. Is it in here? I guess. I'm not sure. What? Come on. I don't know where to go. Okay.
It's over, John. I ain't leaving here without you.
In here? Did he go down the tunnel? I'm guessing. Yeah. Of course he did. I hate how he talks.
I ain't like you.
Oh, there's a ladder. Like, I know I saw him go up a ladder, but I couldn't find it. Okay. Sorry if I'm not talking. I'm trying to focus. So many ladders! Well, at least he's supposed to be far ahead of me for this chase.
You can't erase the past, John! Give it me, it won't make it go away!
You gonna run out of bullets? You keep doing that. Oh, he's shot. Is he going to Peter Pan off the ledge there?
John.
Hello, Dutch.
We gotta stop meeting like this.
Sure.
I got a plan, John.
You always got a plan, Dutch.
This is a good one.
I don't doubt it.
We can't always fight nature, John. We can't fight change. Can't fight gravity.
He's gonna jump in there.
We can't fight nothing. My whole life, all I ever did was fight.
Then give up, Dutch.
But I can't give up, neither. I can't fight my own nature. That's a paradox, John. You see?
Then I have to shoot you.
When I'm gone, they'll just find another monster. They have to. Because they have to justify their wages.
That's their business.
He's gonna jump.
Our time has passed.
I don't think I could do that even if I was very desperate. I just don't think I could.
So at the end, you didn't have the guts to shoot.
The man's dead, Ross.
Sure. Can I see your gun?
No. He's gonna shoot him, isn't he?
Better in the report that way.
Where's my family?
Your wife was killed in a prison riot last week. So, I'm only joking, dear boy. They were sent back to that Scrabble ranch of yours in Beecher's Hope. They're quite safe and sound.
They better be.
Thank you, Mr. Morrison, for everything. I know this wasn't easy for you, but I have to say, done your country proud.
Yeah, exactly. See you around, John. Try to stay out of trouble. Come on, Archer. Let's go find somebody else we can annoy.
So, oh, I get to go see my family, but I don't get to loot. Okay, they're playing a song. I don't know if this is going to be copyrighted. Okay, so I cut out, excuse me, I cut out that whole trip, mostly because of the music. I think it would have been really cool to have the journey with that music behind it. But I don't want to get copyright strike on YouTube. So I'm cutting that part out. And we're here and we're about to meet Abigail. I hope. They better be safe and sound. There better not be another twist. And if this is the end, I'm going to have to find another game soon. Here we go.
See this day again.
You no good hillbilly piece of shit. I thought you was dead. I thought he was dead, John, huh? Where you been? Where you been?
You know where I've been, darling. You know.
You saw Dutch, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw him.
And Bill?
Yeah, I saw him too.
And you didn't go back to him?
I left that life. Just as you left yours. How'd they treat you?
Oh, I can take care of myself, John. One guard got funny on me one time, but I wasn't so ladylike and he didn't try it again. Or no one else.
How's the boy?
Well, like you. And like me. Well, he's like a kid growing up without a father.
That ain't fair.
What is fair?
Well, some trees flourish, others die. Some cattle grow strong, others are taken by wolves. Some men are born rich enough and dumb enough to enjoy their lives. Ain't nothing fair, you know that.
We tried to change. I mean, ain't that what you're supposed to do?
We did change. And it's over now. Jack! Jack, come here, boy.
Hello, sir.
Come here. How you been?
Coyotes ate all the chickens and poachers took the cattle. I tried, Father. I tried.
I know you did, son. I know.
Don't you go blaming me, boy. Don't you go blaming me.
I ain't blaming no one, old man, but since you're still alive, there's four mouths to feed. And no cattle.
That's a nice way to greet somebody. Why don't I get to warm and tender embrace?
Consider the fact I ain't put a bullet in your embrace, old man. You were supposed to look after the place.
I did. Well, I did my best. Thing is, there was too many of them. I thought you was dead. I wasn't drinking.
Hold your excuses until you figured out which one to use. Jack, go get your bags packed, boy. We got work to do. We leave in the morning. Go on.
Yes, sir.
Where are you going?
Well, it's getting kind of dark now, but in the morning we've got to go get ourselves some more cattle.
I've got friends at McFarland's ranch. It's over in Hennigan's stead who can sell us some.
Now, Abigail, I hope you learned to cook.
Yes, didn't I say? Rather than some prison, they actually kept me incarcerated in a cooking school for young ladies.
Why did she push him off like that? Like, I guess it's morning, get your hands off, but, you know, you just got your husband back. Let him stroke your cheek, brush your hair.
Hello, sir.
And then when he leaves, go back to sleep.
Right. We should get moving.
You gonna get on your horse there, lad? There you go, good boy.
Yeah.
Well, it marked the trail for me. But I need to stop right there, because I'm already way over. I don't think it's going to cut much time with me cutting out the two journeys that I need to cut out. So we're going to stop right there. And make sure you tune in to episode 38. It's really hard for me not to just keep going and make this like a 2-hour episode. But we're going to do that. Stop here and move this to the next one. Now, thanks for tuning in. This was an interesting and frustrating journey that we will continue next time. I would appreciate a like button if you wouldn't mind hitting that. And if you're not subscribed yet, I hope you will. And it looks like I'm getting to the end. I'm not sure how much is left. I've never played this, but I really need suggestions for another game to play. So if you have some, please drop them in the comments. In the other comments, please be respectful and clean, but please feel free to comment. And if you know anyone else that would like this sort of content, please share. And that's it for now, and we'll see you in the next episode. Bye-bye.